Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about the route guards, which are basically used for the authentication in Angular application. First, we will see what are the route guards. Route guards in Angular are interfaces which can tell the router whether or not it should allow navigation to a requested route. They make this decision by looking at things like whether authentication is required or whether data is properly loaded. We have different types of guards in Angular. First, we have can activate. It checks to see if a user can visit a route. Second is can activate child. It checks to see if a user can visit a route children. Third is can deactivate. It specifies that can a user leave a route or not. Fourth is resolve. It performs some data retrieval before the route is activated. And then fifth one is can load. It checks to see if a user can route to a module that lazy loads. This is our application we have created in our previous lectures. Now I want to implement authentication or guards on these all the routes. For authentication, we use can activate guard. For that, I'm going to write this command ng generate guard, and I'm giving its name auth, and what I want to implement, can activate. Now what this command will do, it will generate an auth guard and will implement can activate in it. As you can see in this, we have can activate true, which means that can visit route or not. But for the sake of testing, I'm going to define it false. Normally this value will come from the database, and after authentication we will store a value and we will use that value as a token. But now for the sake of testing, I'm using this boolean value. As for the moment, its value is false, which means that user have no access to visit that route. And now I'm going to implement this can activate auth guard in our view student path. And if we run our application now, then we can't access as a user to this view student route, but we can access all other routes like about us, contact us, and exams. As you can see, now I can access all these routes, result, date sheet, contact us, about us, but can't access view student. Why? Because we implement this can activate auth guard on its path. So this is the way we can limit our access of different routes for the users. If you guys notice that here we have a line on this can activate, and what it just say that can activate is deprecated, which means that this function is deprecated now and we can use functional approach. And for that, I'm going to remove this. And this function becomes very simple. And in this route file, I'm going to inject this in a function form. And this is our latest functional form of auth guard. If you are working on the previous Angular versions, like before 12 version, then you can use the previous approach. Otherwise, you can use this functional approach. And this was the today's lecture. Hope you understand this concept. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.